Hey, welcome to chapter 2. In this chapter, we'll add navigation to our application using Expo Router. Before we get started, we need to know about some of the conventions and some things about React Router. First of all, it's a convention to have an app directory on the Explorer. As you can see here, we have this app folder, and this is a special directory, because any files that we add inside this directory will become a screen inside our native app, as well as the web version of this app. We also have this root layout. If I click on it, we have this root layout. And this root layout defines shared UI elements, such as headers or tabs. Then we also have naming conventions. So these layouts, it's always going to be named layout, as you can see here with the underscore. And then we also have this convention of naming index the entry point of the route. So for example, this index.tsx that you can see in here, it's our screen, right? But the route, if we go back to the website, here I have my app running, and the route is not specifying slash index, right? Because we already know as convention that the index is going to be the entry point. Okay, so let's go back to the code. Okay, now we know that the index is the entry point of this route, and this route exports a React component as its default value. And it can use either TSX in this case, or JavaScript, or JS only, JSX, or TS. And finally, we need to understand that Android, iOS, and web will share this navigation structure and conventions. Okay, so now let's create a new screen. As I mentioned before, any file that we add inside this app will be a route. So let's go ahead and create a new file and call about.tsx. This is going to be my about screen. Let's hit enter, and I'll paste some code in here. So in this case, I'm exporting a function component called about screen, and I'm importing from React Native text, a view, and a style sheet. Basically, it's the same thing that we had in our index, but the only changes are that now I have a different name for this route. This one is going to be about screen. Everything else, it's the same. On the right, you can see my device. Nothing is happening yet. The layout is going to define some properties for these screens, right? So let's go ahead and define that the screen that I just added is going to be a stack screen, which means this screen can be presented on top of the index screen that I have in here. So I'll just duplicate this and change the name to be about. We can change more properties about these specific screens by specifying the options prop. So this options prop allows us to access things like the header title, for example, and I want this to be my sticker smash string. And if I hit save, you can see that on my device, now the header says sticker smash. Let me just put a space in here and hit save. And let's do the same for the about screen. So in this case, I want to have options, and the header is going to be about. Because I want to navigate from the index to the about, we can go to the index screen. Because we are using Expo Router for our navigation, we can import a component called link from Expo Router. This link, it's going to take a reference as property. And the reference, as you can imagine by now, as soon as I open this double quotes, I get autocomplete, and Expo Router is detecting that I created a route called about. So I can simply hit enter on this one, and that's it. Now let's add a style for this. The style is going to be from my styles.button, and I need to define this style. So let's go down here, and after text, I'll create a new style called button. I'm defining a font size of 20. Text decoration underline, because I want to give the perspective that this is a link, and then I'm setting the color to be white. Finally, let's go inside this link and let's add some text, like for example, go to the about screen and let's hit save. I'll just take my device and press the go to about screen, and there we have it. Now we navigated to the about screen. So we get this really cool header with the back button, and I can navigate. And also it's worth noting that we can swipe to go back, as you can see here. And we have these really cool animations, which at the end of the day are native animations, right? Now let's see how this looks on our website. This is my website. And when I press go to the about screen, this is how it looks. I can go back and then navigate between. Okay, so the navigation is working great in all of our platforms. And now I want to show you guys what happens, for example, if I try to navigate, I did some zoom in here. If I try to navigate, I'll do slash in this route on web and let's say test and hit enter. Now in this case, Expo Router, it's detecting that we are navigating to a route that does not exist, right? And we have this unmatched route error, but we can actually customize this in our application. If we go back, we can create a new screen. So I'll go ahead and create a new file inside my app folder, and I'll name this one +notfound.tsx. Now this route will display a fallback screen, and this is useful especially when the route is not found, for example, the classic 404 error. So let's go ahead and paste this screen here. Now this is a very simple component, as you can see here as well. We have just a function not found screen, and we are defining a view and a link that is going to take the user back to the main route. Now it's worth noting that you can navigate to any other screen, like for example the about, right? But it's a good practice to go to the index. Index is going to be the entry point, so we don't need to type it, right? So if I just say slash, this is going to take me to the entry point of the application. So let's go ahead and hit save. Now another thing actually that we are using here, it's from Expo Router, we are importing stack. Stack allows us to access the screen properties, as you can see here. We can define some options directly instead of going to the layout and add a new screen, right? We could do that as well, but if you want to add this configuration directly to the screen, like changing the title in this case, oops, not found, we can do it directly using this stack screen. And now if I scroll down, we can see that we are reutilizing the same styles that we used before. So let's go ahead and hit save and let's see the website. And this is how it looks. It's what we expected. We didn't find this route, but now this is a custom UI that is rendering my 404 error, and I can press the go back to the home screen. And yeah, now I'm here. Now this is working out of the box, but we can go to the layout and simply create a new screen that is going to contain our not found screen. And from here, we can define some things like, for example, the header shown equal to false, and the name, which is not found. Let's hit save. Let me change the route to be test. Okay, now we have a different behavior because I said that I don't want to show the header, but if I delete that, I can see the oops, not found header, and then click on the go back. Now, something to notice here is that we are actually pushing this and we have this back button. So in the index route, we can prevent from rendering this by saying header left, and then just render an empty tag and let's go back. This will prevent to show the back button, right? So we can go to the home screen and then we can go about. And then if I change the route from here, I can say test again, which is a route that does not exist. It's going to tell me, oops, not found, go back to home, and it's working just great. Okay, this is going to work as well on iOS and Android, of course. Okay, so far so good. Now I want to create some tabs. The first thing that I'll do is start a group of screens, right? We are inside the app folder. So let's go ahead and create a new folder. And to define this segment of screens, I'll create this tabs folder with parentheses, okay? Now we follow the same pattern as we did before. First thing is to create the entry point, which is going to be a layout.tsx. Then we need to define the screens. Now I want to reutilize the index and the about. So we can simply take these two screens and drop them inside the tabs. So let's say move. And the cool thing about this is that we don't need to change anything about the index or about screen. This is going to work just fine. Now let's go to the layout and we actually can copy some things from here. So I'll just copy everything from the root layout. This is going to be the root layout. And now let's paste it in here. And instead of saying root, I can say tab layout or tabs layout. And the only difference is that instead of being a stack, in this case, this is going to be tabs. So let's import tabs from Expo Router, and I'll just replace these tabs, these stacks for tabs, okay? And hit save. Cool. Now, we have a warning over there. The reason is because we deleted the screens, right? And now they are not accessible in here because now the route changed. Now the entry point is not going to be index anymore. It's actually going to be tabs. And this about screen is not going to be accessible right away. It's going to be inside my tabs. So we can go ahead and delete this from here. And the only screen that I want to left outside of my tabs, it's going to be the not found. The reason for that is because this is a stack, right? And we have, first of all, the tabs. And on top of the tabs, I want to present the not found so that we know that, you know, the routes are not found. Otherwise, if we try to present this not found inside the tabs, the user is going to still be able to see the tabs at the bottom, which is not good, right? So let's just leave this not found outside and let's hit save. So in this case, we have two navigators, one stack, one tab, and each of these navigators has a header. So in this case, what I want to do is just come here, delete everything and say header shown equal to false. This is a property in the options that we can use to prevent rendering the header. Okay, and now this is looking fine. And we have these two tabs at the bottom and I can navigate between them. Okay, so from here I can navigate, but as you can see, I'm getting this warning. I'm not sure why, honestly. So what I can do for now is just go to my root layout and I'll show you how we can prevent showing these warnings just by using the lockbox. And then we can access this method called ignore logs and passing true. And as you can see now, it's working fine. We can navigate between screens in my device and I can also press the go to about screen button. And this is going to take me to the about tab, which is really nice. Cool. Now, actually, because I have these tabs, we can simply go to the index and delete this link because we don't need it anymore, right? We have the tab. So let's go ahead and delete this import and hit save. Now, what I want to do is start customizing a little bit my app because right now we have, you know, this background color that is not matching with the white background color of the tabs or the header. So to do that, let's go to the layout. This is the place where we customize the navigation, right? So the first thing that I'll do is just go ahead and get rid of this header left that I had in here. And let's start by defining some properties for these tabs. We can apply options or properties to each specific screen, but we can also do the same for all of these screens by accessing the container tabs, right? This tag, we can say something like screen options and hit enter. And then from here, we can say something like tab bar active in color, and then we can define this color. And as you can see here, now we have this yellowish color in our tabs. Now, of course, our tabs look very bad. Now let's go ahead and add some icons. So we can import ion icons from Expo Vector icons. And then we can use these icons to replace these default icons that we can see here in the tabs. And inside the options, I can say tab bar icon, and then we can define this icon in here. Now this tab bar icon, basically it's going to take a function that is going to look like this. And from here, I'm going to return a ion icon. Now the ion icons take a name and a size, and you can search whatever icon you want to use. When you open the double quotes, you can search for example, home, and then you can provide the size. So this component, it's going to receive some properties for these icons that come from the tabs navigator. And these properties are focused and color as well. So basically this is a Boolean that Expo Router is going to let us know when this tab is focused. And based on this value, this is a Boolean, we can have some validation on this icon. For example, we can change the color or even the name. So in this case, I'll change the name by adding this validation. The name is going to change depending if the tab is focused. If the tab is focused, I want to use this icon. Otherwise, I want to use this one. So if I hit save now, now I have this icon because it is focused, right? But if I focus now the about screen, we have the outline. Now the color is not being applied. So let's apply the color that we are getting as well from the route. Okay, and this is looking really cool. And now let's go ahead and do the same thing for the about screen. Okay, so I'll just paste this in here. Now if I go to the about, you can see that it's yellow. And when I go away, it's gray. Now let's change the colors of these in the screen options. So I'll just go ahead and paste these styles, right? So for example, we can access the header style. This is going to take an object and I'm defining the background color that we're using here, okay? The header shadow visible is going to be set to false. And then we can also set the header tint color is going to be white. Okay, so if I hit save, we basically change the background color of the header as well as the background color of the tab. And then we set the header color to be white. So now our app looks really cool, right? And I can navigate between these items and everything looks fine. Now, as a bonus for this lesson, guys, I want to show you how we can change the status bar. So if we go to the root layout, we can wrap this inside a tag like this and hit save. And then we can use the status bar from Expo status bar. And then we can use this style to be equal to light and hit save. And now as you can see, the hour and the battery are shown as white. And this status bar is being used from the Expo package, Expo status bar. And now our application looks amazing, right? Okay, and that wraps up chapter 2. In this chapter, we learn how to create a stack and also how to create a tab to navigate between screens, as well as how to personalize and add the style that we want for our navigation. I hope you like this chapter. I hope you learned something new, and I'll see you in the next one.